Hello friends, welcome to my channel. This is Charan. In this video I will show you how to validate the radio button list control using required field validator. Now let's check the results after adding the required field validator. Click. See, here we got a message, please select the sports. If I select rugby, it's gone. If you are a first time visitor to my channel, please subscribe to get the latest updates. Notice in this ASPX page contains a simple HTML5 code with header tags h1, h2 and horizontal line. Now after the horizontal line, I'm adding the controls. One is the radio button list control, toolbox, the radio button list control, here it is. After adding the radio button list control, let's add the list items, ASP list items. The list items for this demo purpose, I'm adding some sports. The property is text, cricket, the second game is tennis, rugby, football. After adding the list items to this radio button list, now I want to change the direction of this radio button list. By default it's a vertical direction. I want to change the direction, repeat direction is equals to horizontal. After that I'm adding a button control for validation, open toolbox, button control, and I'm changing the button text label to click. Now before adding the validation control to this radio button list, first we'll check the output, how it looks at designing part on the browser, Google Chrome. And here we got the output of that code, the header tags, radio button list and the button control. Now my aim is, when a user click the button control without selecting any radio button list items, I want to display the validation error message. For that I am using the required field validator control. Let's switch back to the Visual Studio. After the button control, I am adding, expand the validation folder, required field validator, add that one. After that, the error message, please select the sport. Control to validate is equals to, the control to validate property takes the, I want to control this radio button list. So I'm adding the radio button list control ID, which is the radio button list 1. And I want to display the message, this error message, for color is equals to red. That's it, we have done the complete coding part. Let's check the results on the browser. I'm reloading the browser link. Now let's check the results after adding the required field validator. Click. See, here we got a message, please select the sports. If I select rugby, it's gone. And one important thing is, if you are getting this error message, just in the web.config file, just add this part to fix that error message. That's it.